This is a mandocello. This goes back to the days when giant mandolins roamed the earth, folks. This was actually found in a dry wash in Montana. In fact, not the entire instrument was found. All we really found was this little piece of binding here, and we were able to regenerate it in its original form, its original prehistoric mando form, by putting it in a microwave with a banjo. And this is what came. I think the cheese is finally off the cracker. No, in all seriousness, mandocello is tuned just like a cello. A, D, G, C. Except it has twice as many strings. And it is twice as cool. It was near almost a forgotten instrument. The Gibson Company used to make families of these instruments in the teens and 20s. Back in the day before radio, before TV, back when people actually got together, like after having dinner, and got their instruments out and played music together. And it was a very hip thing to do in the parlor music period. Read a little music. Everyone could read a little. Music was studied in the schools. People had time because they didn't have Blackberries or emails to answer. So play cello music on this. This is a Bach cello suite. Mandocello, you play with slightly different fingerings than you do with the mandolin. The mandolin is, you finger two fingers per fret. So your first finger is in charge of the first two, your second finger is in charge of the next two, and your third finger is in charge of the fifth fret and the sixth fret. So you play a scale like this on a mandolin. But on a mandocello, we use the pinky. Probably the biggest difference in the mandolin and the mandocello. We're also tuned a fifth lower, so A, D, G, C. But the formations are the same. So when you play this chord on a mandolin, it's a G chord. But on this instrument, it becomes a C chord. The other thing about a mandocello is you don't have to play very much, and it sounds great. You can do little two-note harmonies. Three-note chords are huge, and four-note chords sort of take over the world. Fill up. And it really is in the bass register. So if you're playing with a mandolin player, you're really the bass player. Or if you're playing with a fiddle, you become the bass. Wayfaring Stranger.